I'm Evan from Vimo 3D Library. Today, I'm going to show you how to use normal maps and displacement maps in CLO. By using normal maps and displacement maps, you can add depth to textures. Let's start with what normal map is. Normal map is a type of map that displays the surface texture of an object. It achieves this by showing depth through the reflection of light and shadows. While it doesn't affect the actual height of the fabric, it creates an illusion of depth for the viewer. This depth is not real, but rather a visual trick created by the contrast of light and shadows. Let's see how it works in CLO. Click on this icon next to Normal Map. You can observe that the texture's details have emerged on the surface. As previously explained, the actual height has not been raised. Let's see it closer. The default intensity is 10. I'll just increase the intensity value. As the normal intensity value increases, the depth of the texture becomes stronger and more distinct. Let's lower the intensity value now. The depth looks weaker and less distinct. You can also input a negative value for normal intensity in CLO. If you enter a negative value, the texture and direction will get reversed. If you set the negative value higher, the depth of the texture becomes stronger, as it does with a positive value. Now, let's try raising the actual height. To raise the actual height, you need a displacement map, which is also called height map. It modifies the mesh to create the impression of height on the surface of an object. Let's take a look at the example. In a displacement map, areas that are closer to white appear more raised and create a stronger sense of depth. On the other hand, areas that are close to black seem flat and do not appear raised. A displacement map does not immediately show changes in the 3D view. The changes are visible only in the render window. Click the render button in the top bar to open the render window. Click on Interactive Render. Now, let's apply a displacement map in CLO. Click on this icon next to Displacement Map. It doesn't show any changes because the amount is set to 0. When the amount gets higher, you can see that only the white areas in the displacement map, which appear as V-mode, are raised. Let's try using an even higher value. The more the amount increases, the higher the white areas go up. Amount can also have a negative value, but it is hardly used because it makes the surface details disappear. Let's look into the bottom menu now. I'll try altering the value of Shift. It seems different than before, but how exactly does it work? Let's find out with a different view. Shift is a function that adjusts the overall starting point of the displacement map. Let's take a look at an example to understand it better. As the value increases, you can see that the distance between the surface and the map becomes wider. Shift can also have negative values. If you input a negative value, the displacement map will come closer to the fabric surface. If the value of shift is equal to or greater than the amount, the surface may suddenly disappear. So, please be aware that you should always consider the value of amount. Let's go back to the previous project file. Clipping is a function for removal. It gradually removes parts of a displacement map. Let's take a closer look. When you input the value for clipping, you can see that a certain area of the displacement map is removed and the shape of the surface is changed. You can adjust the range of the area for removal based on the value you enter. Let's see how it works with an example. Clipping is also influenced by the amount value, just like shift. If you input the same value as amount, the surface will almost disappear. If you input a larger value than amount, the surface will not be visible at all. Let's move on to particle distance. particle distance adjusts the particle spacing of the generated mesh. The default setting is 4 millimeters. Let's raise it to 10. Let's take a closer look. The heightened shape became distorted. If you lower the value, you can make it look clearer and more detailed. If the particle distance is too low, it may overload your computer. So you should find the appropriate value based on your computer's specifications. Now let's adjust the maps and give a sense of depth to a fabric. I'll also use the desaturation feature from the previous tutorial. You can see that the fabric looks more detailed and realistic by using those three maps: texture, normal, and displacement map. Today, I explained you about how to add a sense of depth using a normal map and displacement map. Next time, I'll come back with how to use other maps to express reflection. If you have questions, feel free to leave comments below. We'll be more than happy to answer. We're gonna make more videos about how to use digital fabrics in various 3D software programs, so I really hope you don't miss out. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe our channel to stay updated on our upcoming contents. See you in the next video!